Life Kids, Pastor Carrie here, ready to tell you about the big God story for this week. Last week, we learned about Adam and Eve back at the very beginning of the Bible in Genesis. We learned how God created man and God created animals and the sky and the earth. But then we also learned how Adam and Eve disobeyed God and they were kicked out of this beautiful garden forever because of their disobedience towards God. So today's big God story, we learn that God is worthy of worship. God is worthy of worship. Worship is just expressing to God how wonderful He is, how awesome He is, and living our lives that way by the way that we obey, by the way that we listen to God, by the way that we live our lives. It's a worship. The Bible tells us a unique story in the book of Genesis chapter 11 about this tower. I want to read it for you today. Genesis chapter 11, it says, "Now the whole world had one language." Could you imagine if our entire world just had one language, how we would easily be able to communicate with one another? I mean, that would be absolutely amazing. Pastor Terrence knows like 5 different languages. I know kind of 2. If we only had one language, that we would be able to just accomplish so much and never have this barrier between anybody in the world. And that's what's going on in this time, that there was no language barrier and they all had common speech. And as men moved eastward, they found a plain in Shinar and settled there. They said to each other, "Come, let us make bricks and bake them thoroughly." So they made these bricks. And God had told them, "Listen, I want you to spread throughout the whole earth and fill the whole earth. That's what I want you to do, spread out." But rather than spreading out, they disobeyed and they gathered together in this one place in Shinar, a place also known as Babylon. And they gathered there and said, "You know what? Let's just build a city here." And while they were there, they decided, "We're going to build a tower. Let's see how big of a tower that we can build." And it says, "Come, let us build ourselves a city with a tower that reaches to the heavens so that we may take a name for ourselves and not be scattered over the face of the earth." Well, the Bible continues to tell us that the Lord came down to see the city and to see what they were building and realized that they were going to be able to accomplish a lot by having one language, but also they felt like powerful and that they didn't need God because they had one language and they had this power to them. And so God was like, "You know, I need this not to happen because I am the God of worship for them to worship. And they're trying to be like me, but God is God. They're not going to be able to be all powerful like Him." So to throw them into confusion, He changed all their languages. And they all spoke different languages. Can you imagine you're building something with someone and then all of a sudden you try to ask for a brick and then these words come out of your mouth and maybe German or French or Spanish, and then you're not able to communicate with one another, throws everybody into confusion, and then they stop. They stop building this city. Exactly what God was trying to get them to do because they were disobeying in the first place. When God told them to scatter and they decided, "No, I think we know better. We're just going to stay together and we're going to build a city with a giant tower. That's what we're going to do." Well, that's not worship to God. So that's a unique story. But then the Bible continues to tell us about a man named Abram. He's also known as Abraham. See, Abram, he loved God. And he had his wife named Sarah. And God was talking with Abram, and He had said to him, "Leave your country, your people, and your father's household, and go to the land that I will show you. Just obey me. If you obey me and follow these instructions, I will bless you." He says, "I will make you a great nation, and I will bless you, and I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing, and I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse, and all the peoples of the earth will be blessed through you." What a promise! So Abram was given this promise from God, and he had a choice to leave everything that he knew, to leave and move to a different place in obedience to God, or to stay put, to be disobedient like the people of Babel. Well, Abram decided that he was going to worship God by being obedient to what God had commanded him. So he walks, and him and his wife Sarah, they go and they follow wherever God is leading them. And they end up in the town of Canaan. And then God continues to bless Abram. He increases, like, his descendants are like the stars of the sky. You can't even number them. But at that moment, Abram and Sarah didn't have any children. So they were just completely walking in faith. They didn't have children. They didn't have any descendants. But God made these promises for them. If they obeyed, God would do this for them. And Abram, at this moment, built an altar for the Lord and worshiped God. And God blessed Abram. So today, we have the choice of how we want to live our life in worship to God. Do we disobey, like those who built the Tower of Babel? Or do we obey, like Abram, and just worship God? Because he is amazing. And we worship God in our church services when we're listening to music songs, and we raise our hands and surrender to God and just telling him how wonderful he is. We worship him by the way we live our life in obedience to what he instructs us to do, of how to live and how not to live. All of it is worship to God. So today, how are you worshiping God? Is it with obedience? Can I pray with you today? God, I thank you so much for these new life kids. Pray that you'll bless their lives as they surrender them to you and worship you. I pray that you would give them a fantastic week, as many of them have gone back to school, that they would worship you in the way that they live, that others would see that they live their lives differently, and that they can tell others about you. God, you are worthy of worship, and we give that to you today in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, New Life Kids, I love you a lot, and I'm really thankful for you. Remember, next Sunday, September 13th, we are doing a combined service at our Stowe campus, and I'm going to have a tent set up for you. I have some goodies just for you, so make sure you show up to our combined service next Sunday, September 13th, at 10 a.m. at our Stowe campus. We're not going to have an online kids service for that week because we are combined. So I hope you guys have a fantastic week, and I'll see you back here in 2 weeks. Bye-bye.